Okay, and how I can disassemble this my car's turbocharger, and it is job that we start for this clamp what keeps these two turbo parts in together, and I open this 10 millimeter bolt and let's go to look at what we can see next. Okay, and now I have opened this clamps, this 10 millimeter nut, this part, and this is specific nut for turbocharger because there is so hot situation, and that's, and then I can open this clamp, and here is this bolt, and this is clamp, and now I need a little bit small hammering hit, or I use this my, and now this turbo clamp, this part is free. Okay, good. And then we can open next part in here, and I believe that now we open these bolts in here, what are 8 millimeters in that area. And I open these bolts next, and we can see what we can find in here. Then I need 8 millimeter wrench, and these bolts, they are easy to open. Let's take first bolt away, and there is this bolt, and there is really 6 of these bolts, and next I remove all of these bolts in here, and then we can look that what is inside situation in here. In that way, good. There is next is good, I continue. Then there is this waste gate, and there is 2 hexagonal this hex bolts, and now I have removed these bolts, 1 in here and 2nd in here, and then this waste gate moves in that way, and then we go to open this waste gate's small pin in here. There is really small metallic pin in here, and when I use my flathead screwdrivers in that way, I can compress this pin in that way away in here, and there is this small pin in there. Good. And then I can carefully open this, remove that wastegate. Okay. And there was really pressure spring in inside in here, that array. And now this wastegate is free, and then I can open this hose, and there is really this wastegate shaft, and then this especially this spring what is inside in that area. Okay, good. But now when I removed this wastegate shaft, now this wastegate is totally open, and we can see there inside. And this purpose is to really open this gate, and then this all exhaust gases go through in here, in that way. Like my finger. Normally this is closed. Okay, good. Okay, and next gate is that I need to separate this exhaust part and then this intake part. This is cast iron, and this is like alloy feel, aluminium, and now there is connection joint in here, and when I little bit carefully, when I hammer these parts opens very carefully, And I have to install in here this lubrication oil. But in when I little bit. Now I need to carefully separate, and I can also rotate these parts, and then then I can separate these turbo parts, and I will do that next. Now this my turbocharger is this my steel vise, and then I have soft rubber hammer, and I carefully hammer this aluminium intake area, and now this turbo's plates opens really nicely, and now one side is free and that one is free, and we can go to look these parts. Okay, and now when I removed this my turbocharger's this exhaust manifold part, now we can see there are these areas where this air, especially exhaust gas, is moving, and it is then making these plates in here to rotate in that way. Okay, and this is exhaust gas starts to rotate this, and this is the turbo's core idea. And then there is interesting specifics, high temperature gasket and protective seals in here, because this part, it is extremely hot when engine and turbo is running. Okay, and let's then take this intake manifold turbo area away in same way. And now when I work with this my steel vise, and I use couple of times my rubber hammer, then also this turbocharger's this intake manifolds, this air area opens, and now we can see that there is specific glue, and this turbo really works so that this plate in here rotates, and then it moves this air in that hole in here, and in that area it goes directly with high pressure in this our intake manifold. This air really goes in that area, and we can see even there is this my screwdriver. There is hole. Okay, really nice engineering. Okay, good. And then in that area there is this hose where this too high pressure air opens this wastegate, what protects this our turbocharger, because otherwise if we have too high pressure and there is too high rev amount, this our turbocharger can damage. And note that that how well these plates they are designed. Okay, good. And they are really, this exhaust plate is different than this intake plate. Okay, good. And then we have next part to open these nuts in here, look, because they keep these plates in position, and there is one nut in here, that one, and here is smaller. And let's go to open these nuts next. And then when we open these turbo bolts, we need in that bolt now this 12 corner 7 millimeter socket, 7 millimeter, size is 7. And then this another side, we need 12 millimeter socket, what fits in here. And then when I open this, we can soon open these bolts, and I install this my tool in the workbench, and then I open these bolts. Okay, and now this my turbocharger's body is in the steel vise, and I have compressed that in here. And then I need this 7 millimeter socket, and then wrench, and there is this my 12 millimeter. And now I open this both bolts in that way. And now bolts, these are a little bit tight, Now this bolt rotates well, and soon one, it seems that this nut is opening. And in that way, okay, this is almost open. And I take then this bolt and nut away, and we can look it closer. Okay, and then there is really situation that these nuts, that one and in that one, opening is so difficult because we need specific tools that I can't open these nuts in now, but don't worry, I will take these nuts open and then we can look in this inside area, and let's continue. Okay, and then when I have finally opened that blade, this nut, we can look in this next bolt area, and there is hexagonal tool, and there are four of these bolts what I need to open, and next I open these bolts and we can look more in inside in here. Okay, and now I have opened these four hexagonal bolts, and now we have next part what we can take away. I have installed this my turbocharger in this my steel vise in upside down, and there is my plastic rubber hammer, and when I hit this lower part, then this lower part opens nicely, and we can see also in here this red glue in here. Okay, and then we can go forward. I swap this my turbocharger in another side, and now we can see there this red glue, this is like gasket glue, because there is now oil in that area, and there is first small bearing in here, in that one, and now I remove this gasket away, and this is actually, this is now gasket, yes, there is so thin, very thin gasket in here. Okay, and then when I take that away, I can take this first bearing out, and here is this, and let's go to look closer. There is really this turbocharger's first bearing in here, and they are these oil-based bearings, and oil lubrication makes this move, and this is very tight bearing. Good. Then there is more of these hexagonal bolts in here, and I open those next. And then there is three of those hexagonal Torx bolts, but those bolts are so tight and difficult that I can't open those bolts. I need some specific tools, but I will open these bolts in another way that we can go forward to look this inner area. And let's continue. Okay, and now I have removed these bolts, and then we can open this copper cover where are those oil areas. Good, and then we can see in their inner area, and there is this area is oil lubrication area, and then there is next bearing what I need to open. And then with specific tool I can take this next body area away, and now we have in here this second bearing, and then this exhaust shaft and propeller, and there is really these parts, and note that there is this small gaskets in here, very very accurate parts. Okay, and this is this turbocharger's final part. And this is really this core unit, and it is really high engineering specific, these steel specific metals in there inside, and there is bearing also. And I have to say that these final parts are really, really difficult to take out without specific tools, because this is so high-tech car component. But there is really this blades. This is like intake areas blade, and this is aluminium alloy, very light. And then this another, this is more heavier. This is like exhaust blade, and there is soft. And note that there is many of these small gaskets in here and bearings. And interesting is that these blades, they are different. And this is really interesting. Look this design. And this was this turbocharger's parts in inside. And in final words, that if you do that job like me, then we damage these parts, because these are so sensitive and these tolerances are so small that I recommend that we purchase these rebuild turbochargers from the specific companies, because they have those specific tools to remove and install these parts back. But this is this ideology that what this turbocharger is in inside. Okay, thank you my friend, and see you in next movie, and be happy and positive.